Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. In this session, let's look into another standard result as part of exponential and logarithmic functions and how to find out the limits of them. So we have very interesting function here. If the function is of the form 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 by x as x tends to 0, so we will try to prove that it is equal to e if x tends to 0. Similarly, if x tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by x whole to the power of x equal to e. If you know the one, you see that you can automatically get the second one, because if x tends to 0, if I take y equal to 1 by x, then y tends to infinity, x will become 1 by y, and y will become 1 by x will become y. So you will get into the same thing anyway. Now to solve that, which one of these to actually go ahead with the proof and try to understand how we got this, which one we have to pick? You can pick the 1 by x or you can pick x. I'll try to take the second one because it's very easy for the expansion. The first one is also okay if you know the rational binomial expansion of rationals. Otherwise, we'll go ahead with this. So now what is this binomial in the form of? It is in the form of 1 plus x whole to the power of n, where your x is nothing but equal to 1 by x and your n equal to x. Now what is the expansion of this? That is nc0 plus nc1x plus nc2x square. You will agree with me, nc3x cube, and goes on. If I expand it a little bit more, nc0 is 1, nc1 is nothing but factorial n, I'll write down one more step for that, factorial n by n minus 1 factorial into 1 factorial into x. Nc2 is n into n minus 1. Okay, let me write it in another way. I will say nc2 equal to, the first step will be n factorial divided by n minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial into x square, plus nc3 will be n factorial by n minus 3 factorial into 3 factorial into x cube, plus, and this goes on. Okay, now let's simplify this a little bit further more and see what happens. This will be nothing but equal to 1 plus, when I say factorial n by factorial n minus 1, you can write n factorial as n into n minus factorial, so I can say nx. And similarly, if you are able to simplify that, you will see that this is nothing but equal to n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial into x square, plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into x cube, let's move little bit, into x cube divided by 3 factorial. I hope you are okay, comfortable with that, right? N factorial by n minus 2 factorial. N factorial is nothing but n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial. So I can cancel n minus 2 factorial, n minus 2 factorial. I'm left with this. Okay. Now we are ready to substitute this in our function. Our binomial is, let me just change the color so that we will, so it is 1 plus 1 by x whole to the power of x. Now if you see, n is equal to x and x equal to 1 by x. Let's substitute that. I'll have 1 plus n is nothing but x, n is nothing but x, and x is equal to 1 by x. I hope you are okay with that. Now what is n again? N is x into x minus 1 by 2 factorial. What is our x? X is 1 by x. So it becomes 1 by x whole square, plus again x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 by 3 factorial. I have divided by x cube, because x is equal to 1 by x. Shall I write it down so that you are not confused? N is equal to x, and x is equal to 1 by x with respect to this formula. With respect to this formula, x is equal to 1 by x and n is equal to x. If you substitute that, you will see that interestingly, we will have 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial into, can I write x into x minus 1 by x square as x by x into x minus 1 by x? Similarly, the next one I can write it as x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 by x by x by x and 3 factorial, 1 by 3 factorial. Now we go back and simplify this a little bit further. That will be our last step we are reaching. So it will be 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1 by 2 factorial into xx cancels, x minus 1 by x, I can write it as 1 minus 1 by x, plus xx cancels, x minus 1 by x is 1 minus 1 by x into, the next term is 1 minus 2 by x into 1 by 3 factorial, and this goes on. Don't get me mistaken that it's finite, it's infinite till you go to the n terms. Infinite means it's finite only actually, till you go to the x terms, binomial expansion. Okay, right. Now, let us say for this function, you are applying a limit and you are saying now x tends to infinity. What happens if x tends to infinity? 1 by x tends to 0. We know that, we have learned it already. So I can substitute that, it will become 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial. 1 minus 1 by x is 0, so it becomes 1 minus 0. Similarly, you can see that 1 minus 1 by x is 1, 1 minus 2 by x is also 1 because 1 by x 0, 2 by x is also 0. So 1 into 1 into 1 by 3 factorial, and this goes on. But this is nothing but equal to e, because the definition of e is the same. 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial plus 1 by 4 factorial goes on. So that's how we can prove that limit x tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by x whole to the power of x equal to e. Now once we are able to do that, automatically we should be able to get limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 by x equal to e. Now let me just take a couple of minutes and summarize this, how we have done that. It's a simple binomial expansion where you have 1 plus x whole to the power of n. So we have tried to simplify that, and then we have substituted in the binomial we have, where we see that from the original formula, x equal to 1 by x and n equal to x, you substitute them, and suppose you say that x tends to infinity, what will happen to this function or this binomial expansion? You will see that it will become equal to e. Now let us try to solve some simple examples, one or two examples based on this particular standard result. Let us look at this example. Limit x tends to 0, cos x whole to the power of 1 by sin x. Now we have to solve this and find out the limit of this as x tends to 0. This as x tends to 0, so we have to leverage this formula. So I have to convert cos x into somehow into 1 plus x form, then I have to make it as whole to the power of 1 by x so that I can say e, then I can again apply the limit. So let me just try to simplify this. I will say limit x tends to 0, first thing first, I should have 1 plus x, so I will write it as 1 plus. If I write 1 plus, I have to subtract the 1, so can I go ahead and say cos x minus 1 whole to the power of 1 by sin x. Now we'll go to the next step where we will say limit x tends to 0, we have 1 plus x, that is cos x minus 1. If you have x, now what is our x? Our x value is, let me just write it down here, our x is cos x minus 1. So what will be our 1 by x? 1 by x will be 1 by cos x minus 1. So to convert this into the formula, whatever we have, like to get E, what I should have now? Here I should have 1 by cos x minus 1. But you see that there is no 1 by cos x minus 1 there. We have just kept it. If you have actually placed that, then you should nullify it, otherwise the value will change. So can I do that so that cos x minus 1 cancels out? Already I have 1 by sin x, so I'll just place it as 1 by sin x. Now you can see that this whole thing is in the form of limit 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 by x. So that is nothing but we know that it is equal to e to the power of this whole thing in the box will become e, and what we are left out is now limit x tends to 0, we are left with cos x minus 1 by sin x. So if you simplify that, limit x tends to 0, you can apply cos 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 by anything is 0, so I don't need to say that, I can directly go ahead and say equal to e power 0, that is equal to 1. So the solution for that is 1. Let me repeat that again. We have been given limit x tends to 0 cos x whole to the power of 1 by sin x. This has to be in the form of limit of 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 by x. First of all, I don't see 1, so let me add 1. If I add 1, I should subtract 1 so that I'll not modify the value. Now if this becomes ax is cos x minus 1, 1 by x should be 1 by cos x minus 1. So to simplify that, I have just kept 1 by cos x minus 1. If I am dividing there, I should also multiply there. So I have multiplied again. Now the whole thing in the box becomes e, so your problem will become now e to the power of limit x tends to 0 cos x minus 1 by sin x. Now you can ask me, why are you doing limit again? Because if you remember, like addition of limits equal to limit of additives, same thing with subtraction, multiplication, division and also exponentiation. So here I have to do e to the power of limit x tends to 0 cos x minus 1. So if you look at this one, 1 minus cos x by sin x, you can see very clearly, even you try to convert this into 2 sin square x by 2 and 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2, you will end up with 0. So e power 0 is equal to 1, or you can directly substitute x equal to 0, you will have 1 minus 1 0, 0 by 0, 0 by anything is 0, so e power 0 is equal to 1. In the next session, we will solve some more interesting examples as part of this standard result, that is limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x whole to the power of 1 by x equal to e, or limit x tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by x whole to the power of x equal to e. How we have solved it? We have taken the second one, we applied the binomial expansions, just substituted the values whatever we have in our binomial to that, and we said that x tends to infinity now. When x tends to infinity, 1 by x tends to 0. So we can see that the value, whatever we got, is equal to e. So I'll catch you in the next session. Thanks for your time. Bye for now.